Hello guys, welcome to UNC virtual class. I am Pragyalin Saho, lecturer of computer science department. Today I am going to discuss one of very important core part of the computer graphics field, that's your CRT, that means cathode ray tube. Here is an outlines which I will discuss on today's class step by step. So now to start, what is cathode ray tube? In generally, the cathode ray tube is a technology which is used in traditional computers and televisions for displaying the images. That means in previous class already I have explained about the images and graphics. That means by using the technology of a computer graphics, we have to create any types of graphical image through the help of different types of program and also different types of data. So how all over the pictorial elements that we display above the part of the visual display unit, in this case one of the technology and concept to be embedded with the video, that is to be called as cathode ray tube. Okay, so but in general term, if we express the cathode ray tube, that to be looks like your vacuum tube, and it to be normally consisting number of electrons and one phosphorescent screens. But here it always to be accelerates, modulates and also deflects all over the electron beam and the screens for creating the different images. So that is to be called as cathode ray tubes. Now to go the next term of the CRT, that's your components of CRT. That means what are the internal components we have used in case of CRT for creating the given image on the display screens. So the first one is the electron guns. So what is electron guns? Generally, the electron guns to be consisting multiple number of electrons and one particular phosphorescent screens and also one cathodes. It is also to be used for creating source number of electrons which is to be reflected on the electron beams for creating any types of images on the given screens. That is to be called as electron guns. Now goes to the second components, that's your control electrode. What is control electrode? Generally, the control electrode to be used whenever we have to display any types of images through the help of electron beams. In this case, how the particular electron beams to be turned on and turned off, that to be handled through the help of control electrode. That means in single words, the control electrodes to be used for turned on and off purpose of the electron beams. Now goes to the next concept, that's your focusing systems. The focusing systems to be generally used whenever we have to need for viewing all over the pictures and the clear format. That means when the electrons that we passes on focusing systems, in this case the focusing systems to be check how all over the pixel points that to be accurately flow on the screens and the picture to be normally created on clearance visual format. Okay, sometimes if the programmer to be needed, if the developer to be needed for adding high level focusing system for high precision system screen display elements, that to be also possible in case of cathode ray tubes. Now goes to the next concept, that's your deflection plate. What is deflection plate? Here there are two types of deflection plate. One is the horizontal deflection plate and another one is the vertical deflection plate. Generally, this deflection plate to be described the direction of the electron beams. That means generally the deflection plate to be creates one magnetic field and also one electric field through which how the electron beam to be directs on the given area where the picture to be produced. That is to be called as deflection plate. Now goes to the next components, that's your phosphorus screens. That means always every CRT that to be internally embedded with its front space, that to be normally coated with phosphorus screens. Why? As in case of phosphorus to be very glow whenever the electron beam to be hits. So that we have to use always in case of CRT screen on the coated format phosphorus materials. Now goes to the next components, that's your control gear. Generally the control gears to be used when the intensity of the particular graphical image that to be controlled by its through voltage, in this case the control gear to be used. That means for intensity of the voltage of the graphical elements to be controlled by the control gears. when the electric voltage is very high negative, here the electron begins to be turned off. When the particular control grid voltage is very low negative, in this case maybe some of the electrons to be eliminated. Then goes to the next concept, that's your resolutions. What is resolutions? Generally the resolution of the picture clarity to be calculated. All over the pixel points we have to check, whatever the pixel points that are not overlapping with each others, that to be normally calculated for the resolution purpose. That means the maximum number of pixel points that are not overlapping with each others, that is to be called as resolutions. Here that all over the internal components to be used in case of CRT for displaying the images. Now goes to the operation of CRT or the anatomy structure of CRT. That's the general structure of CRT. Here you check, this is the structure of the CRT. Generally here the CRT structures looks like your vacuum tube. Here one end of the CRT that to be contains the display pins, and another end that to be contains the control connector pins. Generally here the display pins that to be normally coated with phosphorus thin materials, and that to be normally emitted on few time periods when the electron beams to be hits. So now to check how all over the electrons to be passes and created the given pictures element on the display screens. Initially some of cathode rays are electrons that to be emitted through the electron guns. After that the electron guns to be passing all over the electrons through the help of focusing system and horizontal plate and reflection plate in direction of the electron beams. After that the electron beams to be strikes all over the electrons on the phosphor coated screens. When the phosphor coated screens that to be observing all over the electrons, then it to be created all over the illuminated spotlight spot where the pictures to be written. After that when all over the pixel point that to be observing, then it to be rapidly creating all over the picture element on the format of as the objective given instructions. So this is the structures how all over the different types of data to be converted on the format of graphicals, and also that to be displaying on the above part of the screens through the help of technology cathode ray tube. Now goes to the next term, that's your technology of CRT. That means when all over the picture to be generated on the particular output screen, how that to be generated? That means by using in which way all over the pixel points to be rejoining. It to be joining by using two ways. One is the random scan and another one is the raster scan. In case of random scans, it to be normally created all over the pixel points. It to be arranging all over the pixel points. Whatever the pixel point to be normally contracted by the electron beams, only the contracted pixel points to be rejoining and arranging, and that pixel points to be reconnecting on the format of line format. That's your active time that to be connecting all over the pixel points. Okay, but in case of raster scans, it to be emitted all over the electrons through the help of electron beam on the full part of the screens. That means here all over the electrons whenever to be scattered above the part of phosphor coated screens, here all over the screen to be observing all over the deflection light. So here all over the picture to be generated row by row. So when all over the row by row line to be created or row by row pixel point to be joining, in this case the previous pixel graphical elements to be stored on a given location, that is to be called as frame buffer. That means in case of random scan, only that to be capturing and joining all over the pixel points where the particular light to be emitted. But in case of raster scan, it to be scanning whole screen part of the particular display elements row by row. In case of random scan, as it is scanning only the given pixel point which is emitted by the electron beam, so here the resolution of the picture is very high. But in case raster scan, as all over the particular electrons that to be focusing on the whole part of the screens, so here the resolution of the pictures is very low. But in case of random scan, if we have to draw any types of geometrical object, that will be very smooth and also that will be very clear understanding for the users. But in case of raster scan, whenever we have to draw any types of geometrical object by using different types of mathematical functions, in this case the pictures to be on jiggered format, that means on curve format. Maybe some pixel points have not clear display, okay, but in case of random scan, that we clearly display all over the particular geometrical pictorial elements. But in case of raster scan, if we have to require for using this particular concept, in this particular concept to be used in case of televisions, in case of high level graphical elements, which graphical elements to be normally coated with different intensity with different color elements, in this case the raster scan to be used. For example, in case of random scan, it uses for the line, means all types of geometrical object creations. In case of raster scan technology to be used in case of televisions. This is all about the today's class. If any doubt, then you can ask me with the help of comment box. That's all. Thank you.